Greetings, everyone, and welcome to episode 30. I know, I can't believe we're already there, of Austriff. I am the Beard, and today we start with a bustling industry sector, which we kind of got up and running properly in the last episode. I think there's two more ashworks that are on the way up there in the background, and a few more fields that got put into the sloping hills back there. And I think today we need to continue focusing on clearing that big forest above my head as we expand backwards into the area that is this big, large farmland, or soon to be farmland. I'm going to make it into farmland. But we have also started out on this side. So I think we can start planning now a couple of row houses along this end of the world. Now, this is not permanent, this forestry building here, by any stretch of the imagination. We are going to need a permanent one. So I'm thinking of actually putting another permanent one in now. So let's do that, shall we? As a first order of business while those ashworks go up there. So we've got this beautiful cartworks here. And I kind of want to make this the end of the edge of the industrial sector. So I'm thinking if we do the forestry building right out the side of it, because I think we're going to do more forests here. Let's do this. Should we do this like this? I'm kind of inclined to do it like that, and we'll get some trees behind it to sort of earmark it as forestry. We'll get that in there, and then let's get some spruces in so we can start so we don't lag behind basically on the decoration here. I can't put it in here, occupied, too close to water, but I can put one there and there. This is good. This is starting to help us sort of screen the area, the sort of very heavy production focused area back here from everything else, basically. Maples. I'm sure we can fit something in here. Can we fit one cottonwood? Let's see if we can find one cottonwood spot. I'd like one ideally in here somewhere. Close, too close. Come on, there's got to be a spot. Ah, there you go. I'm sure we can fit one in here. There you go. Cool, so we'll plant that out. And that gets a bit of a secondary forestry going here, just so we can help clear that. And then I think we will get another one. And this will be a non-permanent one, I don't think. This will be a non-permanent forestry. He's going to go deep in the woods here. Ideally, we don't have to cut any trees. It might be near impossible. Oh, it isn't. Look at that. Okay. I'm going to do that there. I know that's a long way away. But they're going to start helping us clear these trees out the back here, I think. I think that's the kind of the rough goal. So let's move those up the queue. We do have this ashworks in here, which is great. This ashery here, and we've got this ashery, and we've got this ashery here that's just doing lye. So this one here, I'd like to just do potash, right? So we just do potash in this one. This one here, we'll just do ash, right? Ash, there you go. And this guy here, let's just apply this to all, and apply to all, and that'll get people working in here. Minimum two, there you go. So we'll get potash. We'll start making stuff here. So I think this here, so let's have a look here at what it says here. So 200 units of bark produces ash, right? Okay, cool. That's cool. Then we need ash can be used light produce lye. Each batch of 25 lye needs 50 units of ash and 100 units of water. So 50 units of ash. So we need two ashes and then produces one lye, basically. And then we need 100 lye. So it's we need 2-2-1, I think, in order to have a good production chain going. So we have that's potash and that's lye. So what's the last one? Is potash is the basic one. So this is potash. We need another lye and another ash. Potash, this is lye, this is ash, and this will be, I think, another lye. And we're going to need another one of these, aren't we? Oh, yeah. Okay. This is why this industrial sector here is so highly, hugely important. We're going to need another glassworks as well. So let's put this guy. Let's put him in here. I want to kind of try to sort of make this a real industrial area here. We're going to put some trees up as well and get it looking a little bit prettier. But this is really all about work down here at the moment. Let's put him in there. It's quite a production chain, this, that we've got to get going here. And then we're going to need another glassworks in as well. And I want that glassworks in over here. Like that. Right. What an industrial sector over here. And that's why I think we're going to need those houses over there. Also, these guys here have got a shorter journey to walk to this construction area here now. So hopefully they can start getting jobs down there too. That would be nice. And then we originally said that a farm here would be really cool. And I think I might have just put that in its place. So actually, let's just take that away. Let's do the farm first. I know this looks weird, but a farm is a better thing to have in here because we're going to need to fill this in, I think. Let's put the farm, though, like that. Yes. Farm in like that. That, and then we'll need to do another one of these still, though. So let's see if we can find a nice spot here. This is uneven. Is this going to be uneven if we turn it around? And just get him in, I think. Just get him in. Facing each other like this. Boom. Okay, so that's all of our... This is a huge production chain going on here. This is a huge, huge production chain. I quite like it, though. I quite like the idea of these massive production chains. Where is the last charcoal pile that isn't this one burning? Do we do apply by all? And then let's apply to all as well. Let's get more charcoal in here, I think. Okay, what did we build there? Did we get another one of these up? It was this. Did we get this guy up? Yes, we got him up. Okay, so forestry. We've got this dude here, and this guy here. Let's just apply to all. Oh, wait, let's take that down to 100%. Yeah. Okay, forestry, you guys can get some stuff employed, and you guys can too. You guys, let's start here, shall we? Start working your way backwards. Start with clearing this. Work towards yourselves there. There you go. Yes. Okay, so you work up there. You guys help with this. So take on this here. Work into this way. Gonna clear this clump here very quickly, I'm hoping. Not only will this fuel the construction of the village, the city. Oh, look at that. No plots for burial. Ha ha ha. So we've already run out of burial plots. Okay. I think we're going to need to find somewhere for another little graveyard that isn't tied to a church. So we've got this little spot out the back here. We could do something out here with a chapel, couldn't we? Or somewhere along here with a chapel. Or maybe even out all the way out this side. Let's do that. Let's do... Where's religion? Let's do a small... Ooh, no. No, I don't want to fly all the way to a chapel. I want a chapel. I want to build a chapel. I'm thinking about using this here. I'm going to make a little market area here. Let's make this a little church, shall we? Up by the barber surgeon, maybe. Let's do... Actually, we'll put him a little bit back. Put him like that. We put him there like that. And then we take some of our decorations and we go these fences like this. Let's pick a nice fence, shall we? That one there. And we go like this. To there. Then we go. We make quite a nice little graveyard here, I think. In like this. Go in quite far. We're going to make this quite a big one. and we'll close it like that. Just so we can get in an arch. I think an arch would be good over like roughly there, don't you think? And then we can connect that and get this in here like this. Come on, can I not get this in? Let's see if we can connect this like that. Hey, look at that. And then we can get some burial plots in here and just make people happy. Just give them some place to bury their dead. I'm going to give a little bit of a gap back here so that we can put some trees down. Okay. There you go. How many are we missing? Just one. Just one. Just one for the moment. Okay. But we might as well space these graves out. Just because, you know, things go... People, when you get a population this big in a village like this, it starts filling up really quickly. In fact, actually, I'm starting to understand that some of the limitations of Ostrif in its current form is probably linked to this. Unless you just ignore it further down the line. Which is always an option, I suppose. You could always just ignore your need for graves. Doesn't seem at the moment to make people unhappy. But it doesn't make people happy either. Okay, I'm just going to speed this up while I continue with this grave construction here. See, it's already another one down there is already filled up. We've already filled up two graves in here already. Which is quite a lot, if you ask me. And it means you have to sit here and do this. I'm sure that Yevgeny probably has a better cemetery implementation / tool in mind. I must say, I do like placing the graves individually. It does give it a very unique feel to it, and it fits in very well with the sort of vibe of the game in general. But it does get tedious, particularly when you're at populations the size of what we are now. And it means you have to sit here and you have to kind of just tediously lay out a couple of hundred graves. Although we're doing quite well here. This gravesite's turning out fairly good. And I think we'll have a little bit more space in here once I've run these rows. Which is good. And do you think we'll be able to get another row in? We might be able to get a whole another two rows in here. No, we're going to get one in, I think. Do you think we'll get another row in? We might. There might be a chance that we'll get an entire row in here. Let's see. Can we do it? No, just out of reach. That's fine, though. That's nice space for trees. That's very nice space for trees. Okay, cool. So that is a lot of that set in. More space for people to bury people. Another plot out there. Ooh, hello. Is this bridge finished now? And there's some weird lines. Thank you very much for... Why is the school attached to the bridge? I am not sure. And we're going to have to think about routing through here. I think this is going to be the main road. They're building more potashes up here. Let's do this farm next, shall we? And let's do finish that ashery, and then we'll do that like that. Let's get onto the glassworks later, everyone. I really want these trees here to be chopped down, because this is going to be the important part, I think. I'm thinking we should actually start now already with some of these row houses. Let's start planning them at the very least. So what I was thinking was, as we run a row basically along here, boom, boom, boom. So let's earmark a corner, shall we? I think this is the corner in here. Like, this is the, wait, that's the corner there. Two trees to do that, which I'm actually happy with. It encourages them to remove those trees. Boom. Okay, that's the corner in. Let's do two floors. And we're gonna get the big one out this way. Let's do boom. We'll do minimal trees that need to be removed here, I think. That's 8. Yeah, that's quite a lot. Okay, let's leave it like that for now. And let's see how fast these guys manage to chop those trees down. But that'll get a few more people employed on this side of the world. Which is never a bad thing. Never, ever a bad thing. Alright. I will be with you in a few moments. I'm just going to do a save and a load so that we can fix and rectify this issue quickly. Okay, we're back, and we've just loaded, saved and reloaded the game and gotten rid of that pathfinding issue to that bridge there. It's good to know that we have it out there, though. And most of our asheries are built out the back here now, so we can maybe start getting these guys going. So this guy's doing lye. This guy's doing potash. I'm maybe thinking that, in fact, this guy here should be the potash dude. Right? Then this guy here should be the lie guy. This guy should be lie. This guy should be ash. And this guy back here will be ash as well. And that'll keep these guys running, I think. Let's apply to all and apply to all. Hopefully get these guys going. This guy's doing window glass. And this guy's going to do glassware. That's the way it's gonna go. And we have another farm in here, which is good because it's gonna mark the edges here, I think, for our farmland that's gonna continue to be developed out here. I'm thinking of maybe putting a couple of houses in here. Can we fit a village house in here? We can. We might be able to. Uneven. Uneven. Not if we do it this way around. Like that. Can maybe fit him in like right there, like a little village house. Yeah, I kind of like the idea of doing this. It's odd little houses sort of like dotted around. And then this here, this guy here, let's do some fields. So we're gonna start you off your first field, and he's gonna go quite literally. That's where the people are gonna walk. Gonna walk through there. So this field is gonna actually run this. Gonna help me with getting this. I think. I want something that's a bit. I wanna be able to too short. Please, where's the. Okay, wait, can I get you to be like this? Like that? Yes! No! Too long. Too short, too long. Too long. Too short. There you go, we can get him in here like this. I think that's what we're gonna do. Yep, that's going to be that farm's first field, right there. And I know it creates a bit of a weird pathway along here, but that's kind of intended. You don't want everything to look sort of too uniformish, if you can get away with it. I'm just going to check in with some of these cart sheds here. There's some here that need repair. Have you been delivered? Right, we're having problems repairing carts. Ooh, there's carts in here and no one employed. Apply to all. Come on, let's get workers in here. I need cart. These ones don't have any carts at all. And you guys need repairs still too. Okay, so this is a problem. We are not producing enough carts. Okay, should I do this glassworks or should I put the houses? They're clearing the trees there. That's fantastic, guys. Well done. Well done on clearing these trees so brilliantly fast. We'll remove these here. Just remove them from the front. There might even be space in here to fit another line of houses. But I do think it's a good idea that we've finally got a lot of stuff out this end of the world. We're going to need more granaries, though. There's not enough food storage here, I don't think. Something to rectify. Perhaps potentially behind the barber surgeon here, we should put... where are our normal small granaries? Small granaries, there you go. I'm kind of thinking of doing a line of small granaries somewhere along here. Maybe out the back of the farm here. Yeah, maybe we do it here, out the back of the farm. Or out the side of the graveyard here. Let's do that. Put in one and two, and then we're going to put a warehouse in. Also on this side here. For firewood and such things. Clothes, warm clothes, firewood. Need to have a stock of stuff close to the village here. Hello, sir. I will sell you charcoal. I know I definitely have charcoal in stock. 1,500. And I probably have sunflower oil as well. I don't have as much as you would like, but I will trade you. Our money is still staying steady. We've gone up over 19,000 now. Which is good. Are we chopping? Okay, so glassworks on there. Let's throw this all way to the bottom. And then I think I might put these granaries up ahead of everything else. Just so we can have them built and stocked before people start flooding into this area to live. And I do think that we should start a bit of a market here, regardless of what's cooking, because that's gonna feed the people who are already living out here. At the moment, they're walking very far to get to a market stall. So I would rectify that situation with them by doing this. And I think we'll start with those three. But I would like to put more in here. I think I might have to put a village well in as well. Only low quality water. That is disappointing. There's higher quality water back here. How about it back here? Higher quality. Here's the higher quality water back here. It's too low to the ground here for good quality water. Like, there's the good quality water. Okay. There's two pumps here already. So maybe we just do this regardless. We just do a little switcheroo here like this. We do a market that runs along here, and then we do trees and benches. Yep, that's what we're gonna do. Okay, let's do it. A little bit more in. Like that. And like that. And like that. But we'll get a cool little market going here. Once these are up, we'll supply the market from here as well. People whose diamonds died of illness, that's fine. Look at these, they're filled up already. We've already got 6 graves in this little area here. This is getting built now, which is great. And then we can start buying from these guys too. The side of the map starting to get busier and busier. Which is nice, because this was the sort of ignored end of the map, if that makes sense. I'm also starting to think that we should probably build another barber surgeon. Now that we know that we can't move this guy. I do think this end of the map does deserve a barber surgeon. But I'm not sure exactly where we put him. I would have liked to have fitted him in here. But I don't think we're gonna do it. I think that, like, these guys out here might have to just survive by using those barber surgeons. And then we build a clump. Because if you have a look at the map, we'll build a barber surgeon out here. We'll build a clump of houses and a barber surgeon here, I think. Somewhere here. And we'll do, like, another little village center here somewhere. And barber surgeon that side of the world. This is going well here, though. We're now starting on these row houses here. Great. I'm just making sure that some of these pines here specifically get removed faster than others. That we've got a clear space here to build and work. Yep. Clear this all, guys. Thank you. Thank you for your service, woodcutters. I appreciate it. And this is good to see this going up on this side of the world here, hey? New constructions. And we've got lots of bricks. So, expending these bricks down here is a good idea. We're almost at a 5 population. 43 jobs. Okay, this is good. I think that this here was a really good idea. So how about we get one in with a store? Row house, two stores, and a floor. There you go. We'll do you like. That. And let's get one with an arch. An arch, yes. And we'll do this guy over here. Yes. The row of row houses. Which is what they're really for, isn't it? And then we'll get this guy over here. One tree there. And we'll do one tree there. And then what we'll do is we'll go all the way out to the corner, and this guy needs a corner cap. Which he will get, like, this. Ah, come on. There you go. Okay. So that's that whole row built there. Let's kick this all the way to the back, shall we? Kick these guys backwards. Let's see what we should, let's set this automatically. That seems like a good thing to me, and let's put some honey in here as well, shall we? 1250 in there. Let's also buy honey and buy apples, why not? Take from other granaries, sure. Let's do that other small granary then. Do this one. This here is definitely gonna need clothes, shoes, and warm clothes and firewood. I 100% want this in here, firewood. What else can we do? Wood. Okay, fine. Yes, wood. Let's do 2,000 of each of these in here. 2,000. Great. Take from other warehouses. Let's get this into apply to all and apply to all. Back to this granary over here. Sweet, we've got honey coming in. And let's just make sure that we have this applied to that warehouse too. That we can get some of these goods in here too. And that means that you can start selling the stock standards. So let's do shoes and clothes and warm clothes and firewood. Firewood, yes. And you, what are you starting? So let's do buckwheat, potato, sunflower, all sorts. Buckwheat. What was it? Oil. Sunflower oil. Salt. And potatoes. Potatoes, right? And then we can do apples, dried fish, honey. Apples. Dried fish. Honey. Let's do apricots as well. And then this one here, we can do all kinds of stuff. So we can do beetroot and chicken meat. And we've got garlic, I know. And we've got carrots. And I want to put glassware in one of these. Glassware. I want to put soap in one of these too. Soap. And let's do cabbage. And let's do onions as well. And then you here, let's do dried fruit and flour and meat. Let's do beef and chicken eggs. Right? Good. Okay, let's get to a market stall that actually has employees. Apply. And hopefully these guys will now start eating stocks. That would have increased the number of jobs. Oh, hello. We're missing some trades here. Buckwheat, no. Charcoal, 2,500. Yes, we're stocking this quickly. It's good. I'll do 5,000 of that. And it's not really affect our money. We're staying solid-ish. We've got more. Have we got any houses available? Are you completely full? Yes, you are. 1,422, everyone. Charles has been born. Everyone's being born. Okay, this is good. This is a good slog here. This is a really good growth effort that we're going through over here. I like this here as the village house for the pub. This is looking grand here, isn't it? In fact, actually, let's see if we get a patron of the arts into here. That would be really cool. I think like this. Yes, we're going to do it. We're going to get a patron of the arts. No, we're going to do it over here. We're going to make this into a square. Yeah, let's do that. We'll put that as a square. And then let's get... we're just doing some decoration around here now because we can. I'm going to run a fence like this. Like that. And then I want to do like a... like a two deep there, like that. And a two deep. And then I want to get a maple. Then let's do a cottonwood. Do close there. There. And then I want to do a birch in the middle. There with two benches. There you go. That's quite nice. Like this little garden cordoned off garden area with like lots of trees by the pub. Nice. We'll do some more trees around here and decorate this a little bit more as we go along. I just want to make sure that these come out here. I don't want straggling trees near the front of the line. It sounds like a war, doesn't it? I don't want straggling trees near the front line. You know what I'm talking about. These trees come out now. And it creates for less headaches and problems later on. Remove all these trees here. That are super close to the buildings. Out they come. More row houses up. Look at this. Vacant. Okay, cool. What are we sitting on now? There's three houses available and still 40 jobs floating around town. It's July, so it's not even harvest time. It's not even harvest time. This is a cow shed. That's the other thing. I also think we should probably get more cow sheds up. Because cow sheds really help with soil fertility. So I was thinking maybe a cow shed around this end of the world as well to help with the fertility on these fields and these fields here. Could be very cool. Plus, you know, more cow sheds equal more manure. We could put one up here, use these cards on these fields. At the moment, we've only got 2 cow herds. How's this herd doing? 21. Okay, maybe we should be slaughtering some of these guys. Or at the very least, making more plows. But let's do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Anyone over 2 years old is going for the shop. So anyone 1 and under can stay. The rest of you are going for the chop. Horses? Fine. Maybe we should get some sheep. Maybe we should finally buy some sheep. Those are the pigsties. Should we get some sheep folds? Use fallow fields and use fallow fields. Let's get some sheep in stock, shall we? Should we buy some sheep? You don't sell sheep. So no sheep from you today. I think today's episode is actually going to be about sheep. All right, let's do this. Hey, what's the mass supply here? We can only do 500. Maximum 500. Why at a time? That sucks. Okay, we'll do 500 water as well. Apply to all of them. And then let's do a seasonal on this one. So I think we have 4. So on season, off season, we'll do a full complement of staff and just half complement on the seasons that it needs. And we'll do a 10 laborers, apply to all. Alright. No livestock and no livestock. Okay, cool. But you can stock. Let's get some hay in. And shall we go shopping for some sheep? He's gonna sell a sheep the cheapest, shall we? Oof, that didn't hurt us that much. Okay. Where are we building? Are we building these? Yes, look at these row houses going up here so fantastically. I think we might have to squeeze in garden house in here, actually. Let's see how we can do this. So they might have to be really thin properties. Because of this here. Maybe what we do is we don't make them so thin. I don't like that there. Ah! That sucks. Or maybe what we do is we move this entirely. Go with me here. Go with me. We do this. Yeah, I'm not opposed to this idea. We still keep this as a pathway. And we just make this a little park in here. Okay, I could go with this idea. I could go with this idea. Hang on a minute. We just need to buy some sheep. You don't sell sheep. You don't sell sheep either. You sell sheep. Shall we buy? They've got 19. Should we buy? Let's buy 10 sheep and 4 rams. And then we'll put 5 and 2. Or let's do 20 sheep, 4 rams. Deal. That's a lot of money. But I think getting sheep in is a good idea. Okay. So running with this idea here. What we do is we do the same thing here now. We just go like this. We put in like a house like that. That still stays as a road. We basically just fitted 2 houses in here. We put this one like this in this corner here. That. I'm gonna move these up the list. They've just finished that one there. This will have vacant apartments, this one. 86 jobs. It's because we're at the height of harvest season, I think. It's all those laborers' jobs there. Okay, but I want sheep now. Yes, finally, we have sheep. Current 24. Okay, let's move these sheep there. So that's 1 sheep, 1 ram. 2, 3... 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then we want another ram. Ram. Awesome. So we should have divided the sheep between these two current 7. Let's do a maximum of 20. Maximum of 20. So that keeps that'll keep us with more milk. 12. And you should end up having 12. Yeah, 12, 12. Cool. All right. So that's got us some sheep. I'm pretty sure that's not a fallow field, guys. I'm pretty sure this is not a fallow field. Did you not plant? Power needs repair. I'm pretty sure that's not a fallow field, guys. Anyway, you can be on there. Regardless. And we should get ourselves some pigs as well, because we don't have any pigs. We've got sheep, we've got pigs, we've got cows, we've got chickens. The chickens are doing fairly good, by the way. We are really going through on there. Roaring through on the chickens. Let's just check. We're on the hatchlings limits, 15. How many are in here at the moment? No chickens in here at the moment. Ooh, okay. Chickens, current 20. Let's move 5 chickens and 10 hatchlings. To this chicken coop here. Right? So this chicken coop here. Can we relocate to this chicken coop? This one here? Cool. There should be a third one here that's running. Good. Good. Okay, cool. Rad. Okay, cool. So we're getting even more in here. So we'll do... Let's do hatchlings at... 20, 30, I'm just trying to up the amount of eggs we get, really. So 15, oh no, wait, this needs to go up to 20, 20, there you go. Let's get more chicken eggs out, guys. Let's get more chicken eggs out. Okay, I don't want to do trade, I don't want to do trade, but I do want to end off this episode by stopping the camera right over here and watching these beautiful new row houses go up. So I think like, we've solved a lot of our problems, guys. We went through a period of time with much turmoil within the village here. But I think that now that we've got a couple more bridges and our carts are up and running, thank you everyone for those suggestions on the carts. We've stabled ourselves out a bit. We don't seem to be experiencing people leaving anymore. At least I haven't seen any notifications pop up. I might have missed one or two. But more row houses down this end of the world. Isn't that good? Right. I hope you've enjoyed this week of Austria. I have. I will continue with this playthrough. We're aiming for 2,000 population now. So I'll see you next week. Till then, look after yourselves. Stay safe. I am the Beard. Signing out.